brought to you by Gitanjali Salon, Channi Himmat, Jammu. Follow Ruchika Makeovers on Facebook and Instagram for best bridal makeup in town.
Hello viewers, you're watching Jammu Links News. I'm Manat Gupta and welcome to the daily updates of Midday News. Let's begin.
The UT government on Monday withdrew the controversial SRO-202 that made it mandatory for a new appointee recruited in Jammu and Kashmir to work on probation at the minimum scale of pay for a period of 5 years. This was revealed in a tweet by Union Minister of State in the PMO, Dr. Jitendra Singh. The job policy will not be applicable in new recruitments by the UT government that has set the process of filling up nearly 10,000 posts during the next few months. About nearly 12,000 to 13,000 youth who were recruited by the erstwhile BDP-BJP government in the past, sources said that their probation period also stands reduced to 2 years. Security forces on Tuesday neutralized 3 terrorists in an encounter in Turkwangam area. A top commander of Hizbul Mujahideen is reported among the killed terrorists. After receiving a credible input, the local police launched an operation with army and special forces units. The search operation is underway. Director General of Jammu and Kashmir Police Dilbagh Singh on Monday said 27 terrorists have been killed by security forces in the past 17 days in the valley, causing frustration among militants who are now targeting innocent people. The DGP, who was in a security review meeting in Dodra district, said these terrorists are hitting innocent and soft targets. This has not only annoyed the government but also the people of the Kashmir Valley. Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh on Monday launched first ever feedback call center for COVID-related grievances. He also interacted online with citizens whose grievances have been successfully redressed on the COVID-19 National Monitor for Public Grievances. This is the first time that a senior minister of government has interacted live with citizens who had filed grievances during COVID-19 and thus paved way for other ministries to take up citizen grievances in an effective manner, along with a feedback mechanism. The Jammu and Kashmir unit of BJP on Monday donated another ₹1 crore to the Prime Minister CARES Fund. This was the 5th installment made by the J&K BJP since the start of the coronavirus-driven lockdown, raising the total donations by the unit to the PM CARES Fund to ₹5 crore. J&K BJP President Ravindra Raina handed over the cheques worth ₹1 crore to Chairman J&K Bank R.K. Chibber at Zonal Headquarter. The donations have been received from party functionaries, including former legislator, government employees, businessmen and common citizens including students, men, women and children. Jammu Municipal Corporation on Monday launched the home delivery service of birth and death certificates to avoid public gatherings at its headquarters in view of COVID-19 pandemic. The initiative, named as Doorstep Governance, was launched by Jammu Municipal Corporation Mayor Chandramohan Gupta and Deputy Mayor Purnima Sharma in presence of Corporation's Commissioner Avni Lavasa. The initiative was being taken to promote Digital India and e-governance initiative. The authorities in Kashmir on Monday ordered the partial opening of Mughal Road, the alternate road connecting the valley with the rest of the country, for transportation of fruit produce to markets outside the Union Territory. However, the order stated there would be no passenger vehicular movement on the road and the timing of the movement of trucks would be from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. only. The National Generic Document Registration System was launched in Jammu and Kashmir on Monday. The new system aims to facilitate public with a transparent and hassle-free registration process, he said. Advisor to Lieutenant Governor K.K. Sharma, he launched the NGDRS developed by the Department of Land Resources through the National Informatics Center. The new system will aptly address the diversity and variation prevailing across the Union Territory on account of languages, processes and formats. Divisional Commissioner Sanjeev Verma chaired a meeting of Urban Transport Environment Improvement Committee to review and discuss the traffic management plan for AIIMS Jammu. It was decided in the meeting that the sound barriers and dust barriers shall be managed by the NHAI and CPWD, shall make service roads and appropriately barricade the national highway to stop pedestrian crossing, ensuring free flow of traffic on national highway. A PDP councillor joined BJP on Monday, pledging to strengthen the party at the grassroots level and working with the increased energy to serve the people for their welfare. Advocate Jasmeet Kaur, who was also PDP's Women Wing Vice President, received a welcome into BJP fold by J&K BJP President Ravinder Raina and other senior leaders. Praising the former PDP leader for her decision to quit her old party, Raina alleged that the party has betrayed the trust of the people. An earthquake of magnitude 5.8 hit Jammu and Kashmir in the early hours of Tuesday, officials said, the third to hit the Union Territory in 3 days. However, there was no reports of any damage, they said. The earthquake occurred at 7 a.m. and its epicenter was in Tajikistan. Strong tremors were felt in most parts of the Kashmir Valley, including Srinagar, Kishtwar and Doda districts. Tremors were also felt in Jammu. With an increase of 10,667 cases and 380 deaths in the past 24 hours, the COVID-19 count in India has reached 3,43,091 on Tuesday, according to the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. It is noteworthy that today's spike in cases is lower than the 11,502 registered in the country yesterday and has also stayed below the 11,000 mark it had been crossing for the past 2 days in a row. However, there is an increase in the number of deaths due to the infection from yesterday, with 380 deaths being reported from across the country. The toll due to COVID-19 has now reached 9,900. The Jammu and Kashmir government has evacuated about 140,198 JK residents stranded in other parts of the country due to COVID lockdown via Lakhanpur and through special trains and buses till date amid strict observance of all necessary guidelines and standard operating procedures. As per the official data received in this regard, the Jammu and Kashmir administration has received 54 special trains at Jammu and Udhampur railway stations from different states and UTs so far, with about 42,927 passengers, while about 97,271 persons from other states and UTs, including 327 from abroad, have been evacuated by the government through Lakhanpur till date. Principal Secretary, School Education Department, Dr. Asghar Hassan Samoon has said, government is committed to facilitate private investors to invest in education sector through Education Investment Policy 2020. He was speaking at a meeting convened to discuss implementation of EIP 2020 with several private stakeholders. Threadbare discussions were held while seeking inputs from the investors to establish private colleges and universities and to explore opportunities to attract private investors for the same. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will interact with the chief ministers and heads of 21 states and union territories on Tuesday. The meeting with heads of Punjab, Assam, Kerala, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Tripura, Manipur, Nagaland, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep among others, is scheduled for 3 p.m. today. A similar meeting with heads of the rest 15 states and UTs is also scheduled to take place tomorrow.